In this video, I'm going to be building, or actually rebuilding, my Arcade Pi. It's a 3D printed case which I found on Thingiverse, which houses a Raspberry Pi and an arcade joystick. I made this so that you can use it without the use of a power supply, and it uses a battery to power everything. This means all you need to use to play the Arcade Pi is a HDMI cable, and was actually the basis I used for my Lunchbox Arcade. I made it so long ago, I have a video of my daughter playing it back in 2021. But this time, I want to up the ante by using the latest Raspberry Pi 5 16GB model. First of all, I downloaded the model from Thingiverse. Although it seems like no one has yet remixed the Raspberry Pi 5, or they have and I'm rubbish at searching. As there were a few changes from the Pi 4 and the Pi 5, I had to make the changes to the model. I brought it into FreeCAD, which I had to modify it to be able to remodel. It's exported as an STL file. I then filled in some holes which didn't need to be there. I then had to create the holes for the Ethernet and USB ports. They actually switched it around on the Pi 4 model. The Pi 3 and Pi 5 have the same ports in the same positions, so I have no idea why they switched it in the first place. I then filled in the hole for the headphone jack. Personally, I would have liked if they kept that in the Pi 5. I then added a hole for another button to be at the front, and then two holes for the power switch and charging port. And that about concludes the remodel, also a thought, more on this later. After printing my parts, I changed the bed mat of my printer, and annoyingly the 3D print adhered to the bed so much, I had to reheat the bed to get it off. And this is where I realise I'm going to have to do more remodelling, and the buttons didn't fit in the holes. I then bought a magnetic bed, and I have no idea why I didn't do this years ago. It made so much of a difference and easier to take my prints off. The next thing I had to remodel was the hole for the USB port. The measurements were the exact dimensions of the ports, which made it very difficult to fit the Raspberry Pi into the case. The charging port seemed to fit in fine, but the power switch did not. So on to the remodelling. I first began by adding another hole at the front, so I have two buttons at the front of the case instead of just the one, followed by tweaking the power switch radius. As I had printed the case in two parts, it meant I had to glue the two parts together. I first began by sanding down the edges, first with a coarser grit sandpaper, and then a finer one. I then used some epoxy resin to bind the cases together, and taping both halves with some painter's tape. Once dried, I removed the tape and done a little test fit to make sure it fits correctly. The next part was wiring up the joystick USB. I used the four pins from the USB on the Raspberry Pi and tried to solder the wires to it. I found this a little difficult, and the pins on the Pi 5 were sunken in and didn't seem to solder very well. You can see I've done this with my first Arcade Pi on the Pi 3 and there were no problems at all. But for some reason, it did not seem to work on the Pi 5, so I had to desolder everything and think of another solution. I decided to revert back to using the USB. I found an angled USB lying round in my parts bin, so I stripped the wires and soldered the joystick wires to the USB. And luckily, that seemed to do the trick. Although it does mean I have a piece of wire hanging out from the case. Next thing was power and battery. Same as the Lunchbox Arcade, I used the LiPo Rider boosters. I connected the power switch, charging port, and two cables to power the Pi. Almost to the finish line, I had to assemble everything together, starting with the joystick and buttons. I then screwed down the Raspberry Pi and joystick board. And then the power switch and charging port, which then had to be resoldered onto the LiPo booster. I used the pins to connect to the 5V and ground on the Raspberry Pi GPIO to power the Raspberry Pi. and then added the 8,800 mAh battery, which was stuck on with some tape, and pieced the final pieces together. For this build, I used Batocera as the front end. All you have to do is connect the SD card to your PC and download the latest image of Batocera from their website. I used Belina Etcher to flash the image to the SD card, and once done, eject it and pop it back into the Pi. And here it is in action. There are some emulators that require an analog stick as well as a D-pad to work. Here I've connected a Bluetooth controller. Simply disconnect the arcade joystick and you should be good to go. The Pi 5 is even able to upscale the image to a 4x resolution. The great thing about Batocera is that they have a plug and play solution for my Sinden light guns. Simply plug it in and it will be recognized automatically by Batocera. There are some games that will require some tinkering to get it working. This video is sponsored by PcbWay. If you have a project that requires custom PCBs, 3D printing, or CNC machining, PcbWay will take care of these with absolute professionalism. Simply upload your project in their easy to navigate website and you'll be given a quote. Once a PcbWay representative reviews your project, I actually forgot to document this, but the model actually had an issue with the thickness of the print and the filament I chose. PcbWay was able to give me a description along with an image of where it could go wrong. And after about a week and a half, it arrived. The yellow and blue one was made with a PETG filament, and the grey one was made with regular PLA. PETG is able to handle higher heat compared to PLA, and may be helpful as the Raspberry Pi can get quite hot, but I have included a fan to cool it down. The fitting is pretty snug, but I think it will wear down a little when opening and closing a few times. Not that it means much, but the PETG is a few grams heavier than the PLA. To make a few additional upgrades, I decided to swap out the battery with the UPS Module 3S, as this was rated at 5 volts and 5 amps. I also had a spare M.2 SSD along with an adapter to fit onto the Raspberry Pi. All I need to do is flash the image by using the M.2 SSD enclosure. So all that's there to do is remove the parts from the case to the PcbWay case. Fitting the SSD module to the Pi was as simple as putting these spacers between the Pi and the SSD module and screwing them down. When I eventually placed it back into the case, I wasn't able to screw it to the Pi and just stuck it down with some tape. I then chose to solder the wires to power on the Pi, as I did notice some random power issues when I used the pins. And then finally plugging in all the wires to the joystick board. And finally closing it up and calling it done. When I tried testing the Cinden light guns, it did not seem to work on my TV and was not able to track the guns on the screen. I'm not sure whether it's due to any glare on the screen or whether it was the brightness of the screen, but I could not get the light guns to work on my TV. But it definitely does work, as you can see on my smaller monitor. If there's any interest, I have also made a smaller arcade Pi, so please comment down below if you want to see that build. I've also left all the parts I used in the description below if you feel like building one yourself. Thanks again for watching, and I'll catch you on the next one. Cheers!